In today's Community Focus, a look ahead for you. We are a little more than a month away now from another election here in Rhode Island. Secretary of State Nelly Gorbea joining us live via Zoom to break down what is happening and why. Secretary, thanks so much for joining us at 4.
Thank you so much, Brian. Yes, believe it or not, we have another election on the way.
So we'll kind of back up a little bit here. March 2nd is the date of this special election. It's focused primarily on bond questions, totaling about $500 million. Typically, this would have happened in November. So how did we end up with another election so quickly?
Well, as you're right, usually we would have had these questions at the end of the November ballot, but because of the economic uncertainties that the pandemic brought about, the General Assembly and the governor saw it fit to be more cautious and make sure that when we issue these bonds, we can actually pay for them. And so they wanted to wait till a little bit later on. So the result of those conversations is that we have our own standalone bond election for these statewide bonds, totaling $400 million, and that your elected leadership believes, we can deal with.
An important note of why every Rhode Islander should care about every election, specifically this one as well, a range of bonds for a number of topics. This is not free money, though.
No, it's not. These bonds get repaid with taxpayer money, and this is why Rhode Islanders should absolutely take notice. And we want to make sure that all Rhode Island voters know that they have a voice in this, on whether or not the state should issue bonds, should borrow money to pay for investments in education, in housing, in childcare, in the environment, in infrastructure. These are all really big decisions, and we ask every single Rhode Island voter, what do you think?
On the topic of money, it does cost money to hold an election, specifically a special election like this one. $1.5 million allocated to hold this one coming up next month. Is there anything being done to pare down that cost to do these?
Yes, we always look to make sure that we can save as much money as we can because these are taxpayer dollars. And so, for example, we're using the same envelopes that we had for the November election. So we've saved a lot of money there. We have had some leftovers there. We are also going to be using fewer polling locations that will be open on March 2nd. Only 57 polling places will be open compared to the 421 that would have been open back in November. That's per the Board of Elections, is the agency that decided on that. And then just a few weeks ago, I actually distributed a little bit over under $250,000 to the cities and towns from a grant program that I applied for and was able to get monies for, so that the cities and towns can cover some of the extra expenses of this bond election.
And you started mentioning some deadlines, some key dates to keep in mind, specifically with this Sunday already is the deadline to register a vote. What's on your mind that you say people need to at least have these dates in mind?
Yeah, absolutely. January 31st is our deadline for being registered or to update your voter address. So if you've moved from one town to another, you want to make sure that the address is correct. So I encourage all Rhode Islanders, whether you've moved or not, go to vote.ri.gov and check your voter registration. See what it says there. It's always good to check on that. Further along the line, we will be holding, the mail ballot applications, for example, have been sent out to every single active registered voter, and we will need those back to Rhode Islanders as well. And we need to, and that happens by February 9th. We need to have received mail ballot applications by February 9th. February 10th is the beginning of the 20 days of early in-person voting, which will happen again. And finally, March 2nd is Election Day. So Rhode Islanders will have three ways to vote, just as they did last year, safely and securely. You get to choose what your comfort level is and how you want to vote.
And Secretary, we have about 30 seconds, but you mentioned safely and securely, a big topic from November. What is your message to voters on that topic right now?
You know, every person, every voter's situation is different. Just make sure that you are able to vote, whether it be from home, early in person, or on March 2nd. Your voice is your vote on this very important election on March 2nd. And go to vote.ri.gov if you need more information. It's all there for you.
Secretary of State Nelly Gorbea, live with us at 4 o'clock today. Thanks so much for your time.